Tom, thank you for joining me today at Crossroads Arts Center. And we're going to do a little artist talk and talk about your photography and how you got into this. So let's start with that. What inspired you to take photography on as an art form?
Well, when I went to college, my degree was biology. And one of the things that I did is I worked with an electron microscope. And with the electron microscope, whatever you did had to be made into a photograph, which was then developed and printed. And that's how I first learned how to develop and print film, which was really very interesting to me.
That is interesting. I didn't know that is the way that you would do that. So I love learning things like this. Yeah.
So then after that, while I was working my first job, I went to the Art Institute of Pittsburgh for night school for photography, back in the days of 35 millimeter cameras. And I learned a lot about photography then. I even had my own darkroom at home and I did my own printing. And so that's how I really got into it in the first place.
Tell me some of your favorite subjects. Say, I know a lot of it involves water and reflections, which you do very well.
Well, one of the things that I really like to do is close-up photography. I've always liked to take a look at very close things, and some of that I'm sure comes back from my biology days, looking through the microscope and doing that. For example, this photograph here is a close-up of a fairly small flower. But I like that type of detail, bringing out the detail in a very small flower that you wouldn't really see otherwise unless you really looked at
beautiful.
It. So that's the sort of thing, that's one of the things that I really like to do a lot, is that type of close-up photography.
And then we were talking before we started this about some of the reflections. And this is just amazing, the reflection that you get with the water and all the colors. It's just gorgeous.
Thank you.
It really is. Now, I know one of your favorite places to go is Lewis Skinner Botanical Gardens. So tell us how you started going there and what inspired you to do that.
I started going there on a regular basis just to photograph the flowers. And then as I was doing this, I thought, well, let me go. I was really going about once a week if I could get there and spending a couple of hours, because every week it was amazing this past year how much the garden changes from week to week. I'd go back 1 week and what was blooming last week isn't there anymore, but there's something new blooming. So there was always something new and different to see. So I kind of documented that through the year. And then I met some people at the gardens while I was doing this, and I got to talking to them. And one of the things that I've done with them is I've helped document some of their things that they have in the gardens for them. And then I also, whatever I take, I share with them in a Dropbox account so that they can make use of it for their social media or whatever. So that's been very helpful.
That's really good. And then I know just through personal knowledge that you mentor at times. You've been doing some things with Kim Brundage.
Yes.
And she so speaks highly of you and has loved shadowing you and being with you and has learned so much. So I always believe that part of the art or part of the craft is sharing it.
Yes.
So thank you for doing that.
It is fun to do that. And it's fun to be with another photographer.
Yeah.
And because we all see things differently. And so getting another person's perspective on something is always very helpful. And I've seen a lot of Kim's photography. She does of her headshots and so forth. And she's just amazing at that. So it's amazing to work with somebody who takes an entirely different approach to photography than I do.
Exactly. The marrying of the two.
Yes.
To see how you actually both take to a subject is quite interesting. What else would there be to talk about? So now that we have a new grandbaby, are we going to start seeing more people?
Yeah, certain people. I don't do a lot of people photography.
Yeah.
It's something that, I've just never done so much. I mean, I'll do, occasional portraits and so forth, but that just isn't what I do.
Yeah.
And in fact, I was at the gardens the one evening a few weeks ago, and I was out there with all my equipment taking some photographs, and a couple came up to me and said, do you do portraits? And I said, quite honestly, that isn't what I do, but I know somebody who does, and I gave them Kim's name.
Yeah.
So
it's a good sharing.
It is.
Well,
yeah.
Where would you say is the most interesting, intriguing place that you've been to photograph on your travels?
Well, I would have to say at this point it was Hawaii. We went there for our 40th anniversary last year, and it's really the most beautiful place that I've ever seen.
It was gorgeous.
It was just beautiful and beautiful in different ways than I expected it to be. The Big Island going from a rocky desert to very lush areas on the north end, that was very amazing.
It's pretty incredible.
So if you had just a couple hints or suggestions to give to someone who wants to take their photography a little more serious, what would those suggestions be?
I think the first thing is digital photography, as far as images, is cheap. Take a lot of pictures. Mm-hmm. And then when you're editing your photographs, be ruthless. Look at them and realize what's good and what isn't, and get rid of the ones that aren't good. But then look at them and say, what did I do this time that I could have done better? And then go back out and try it again.
I think that's perfect advice.
Well, I want to thank you for spending the time. This has been wonderful and giving us a little insight into the photography that you do.
Okay, well, thank you.
That's my signature. We end in a hug.